So this is Questo. We are backstage in the band room at the Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon with three really awesome dudes, De La Soul. We have a few questions that our fan base asked. We have Robin D. Boyds 15, mm-hmm. and they asked, how did you choose the name De La Soul?
Oh, yeah. Man, my family is Haitian. And a little bit of that lingo, a little French in there, a little broken French, had me thinking an option or alternative other than Of The Soul.
Right.
Thought it was a cool name, Of The Soul, coming from the soul. And I was like, well, let's spice it up a little bit to try De La Soul.
Was that the only name that you guys have chose? Because a lot of groups, like, we went through four names that are very embarrassing before we got to the Roots.
Yeah.
What were the other names of the group?
Honestly, The Threesome, that was the name. That, just me. Because prior to being the three guys, it was four of us, and before even that, it was just myself and Paz. Myself and Paz was down
Easy Street
with another two, that, and we would call Easy Street.
Right.
Broke off from them, and then Mace came along with Charlie Rock. Charlie Rock eventually left, and that's when we came up with De La Soul.
Now, obviously, Maceo, you're Vincent Mason, so that's how you got your name.
Yeah.
Paz, mm-hmm. Posthumous. Explain the genesis of your name. How did you get that name?
I used to, you know, I wanted to rhyme, so I used to call myself, or made up a name called MC Legiticus.
Way more than that, yeah.
What?
MC Legiticus.
Yeah, I love music always, so, you know, I always tried to, like, play around with DJ.
Right.
But when I started to rhyme or write rhymes, I was like, you know, I wanted to be logical and smart, like Cool Keith. So I called myself MC Legiticus. So when I decided to go back to trying to DJ, I figured, well, like, let me just put the words, you know, backwards, like it was like sop sounds. One of the names I wanted to call Easy Street was sop sounds. Dave was like, nah, and a lot of them was like, nah, I don't like that name. So I was like, well, let me use it, DJ Sop Sounds.
I see.
So when I turned Sop backwards, it became Paz, Sound became Denise.
Now, Dave.
Yes, sir.
Of course, you were formerly Chukoy the Dub.
Yes, sir.
And then after Balloon Mind State, your third record, you just became Dave.
Yeah.
Why that?
I was going through something, I think, at that time. A little fed up with the industry, a little discouraged, just being a young kid and seeing so much happening at a fast pace,
right,
kind of discouraged me a little bit. And I just felt like, you know, this is no longer an act. I'm no longer taking this character up or this person up. I am Dave. I'm just going to keep
so true. So Chukoy is dead?
Chukoy is...
I thought you just stopped eating yogurt.
That's oh, no. I still eat yogurt. I love yogurt.
Chukoy is yogurt backwards, by the way.
Chukoy is still alive. And, you know, I got a lot of fans that call me, Chukoy along. Even some
behind your back, I do still call you Chukoy.
Yeah, some friends around the way still be like, yo, Chukoy. And I got
New York loved it because they thought he was 5% Nation.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right, so Papa New Guinea asks, who have you most enjoyed working with? You guys work with a lot of people.
Yeah,
you work with Shaka Khan, David Byrne.
Mm-hmm.
On this record alone, there's how many? Well, who have you worked with, and who were like the
Maceo Parker was one
that
of
was
the highlights.
Most fun.
He was so much fun. Him, Pee Wee Ellis, and
that's on the Balloon Mind State record.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that was a lot of fun. I mean, they told us a lot of great James Brown stories, and just to see them work.
It was funny to see Tariq play Pee Wee Ellis.
James Brown.
Because that very story Pee Wee told in the studio.
Mm-hmm.
So it had me reflecting on that and had me bugging out. Because Pee Wee told one of the stories they told about James Brown, how Pee Wee used to tease James because he used to
imitate James.
Yeah.
Right.
And they really said Maceo and James Brown used to bump heads a lot.
That's crazy. So Adjuster asked, how long did it take you to create 3 Feet High and Rising, your debut record?
Man.
Well, I know your first record is like your lifetime's work.
Yeah.
It's such a dense, complex record. How long did it take from beginning to end to make that record?
I don't remember.
I would say...
It couldn't have been that long, though.
Nah, I would say 85. Things started materializing when we were playing around with little samplers like SK1 and SK5 Casio samplers, putting them up to the speaker, recording it to a 4-track, you know. A lot of ideas was coming around like 85. I remember we did Ghetto Thing like different ways.
Was it a year? Was it 5 months? Was
in terms of like...
How long it took us to record the record, do you remember?
It couldn't have been.
The actual album itself? I would say 2 months.
Yeah, it wasn't long.
That's quick.
Yeah, it wasn't long at all. I mean, we were basically going up there with a lot of homework done. That's something that, you know, Principal was like key on, getting the work done before you get into the studio and having it ready. And for us, a lot of it was so spontaneous, and we recorded and kept everything. So we was knocking out stuff quick.
I see.
Yeah.
All right, so Short Kid Deep Voice asked. That's right, his name is Short Kid Deep Voice. He says that basically a lot of new rappers in the game don't necessarily know the history of the genre. And do you think this is a problem? Do rappers have a responsibility to know their history, or is it just looking ahead? Black people are not necessarily nostalgic.
Nostalgic, historic.
That's true.
Yeah.
Even with you guys, like, if people come up to you and be like, yo, like, Saturdays was my favorite, like, they, or say like, oh, when I was in first grade, like, do you kind of cringe a little bit, like, just tell me I'm 90 already, like.
No, I don't think we look at it like that, honestly.
Were you proud sages?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, well, it's a blessing to have people, you know, let you understand where they were and what your music means to them. And I think it's definitely important. I don't necessarily feel like it's like everyone's responsibility, but it is sad that a lot of kids don't know their history. They'll know a lot of stuff about violent and gangster stuff, but they won't even know the basis of where hip hop came from.
I kind of think that maybe because the internet gives you so much information that it's like it's overwhelming. Yeah. You ever shop at Jerry's record store in Pittsburgh?
No.
All right, so there's, imagine like Amoeba, but times like 10.
Right, so much in there.
You never get past the letter C,
right?
And it's like 9 hours later. I think it's so much information that it's overwhelming.
Yeah,
so.
I agree with you. But I think there is a part of hip-hop, historically, what's happened, who were the key players, some important things that you should have some sort of knowledge of. A lot of these kids don't.
Yeah.
And I think
so. You can't know where you're going unless you know you can.
Absolutely. Yeah.
True. All right, so Too Fat Canada asks, I'm a huge
names.
Too Fat.
Do you pick them because of the names?
No, I was handed these questions. I'm freestyling. I'm a huge fan. Well, it's Too Fat. I'm a huge fan from Vancouver, Canada. And I always wanted to see a... Oh, really? I always wanted to see a De La Roots collab. That's what I got it.
You set this one up, dude.
No, I didn't. Okay. Too Fat wants to know if De La and the Roots, wherever. Wait, I'll go even further because there is some news out there that's going to rock the hip hop world when a well known, established rapper might play the Billy Preston to somebody's Beatles. So, can I join De La Soul?
What?
Never mind. Thank you very much. This is tonight's show.
We're trying the Roots. How about that?
All right, we'll trade places. Y'all take this gig. I'll go on the road. Thank you very much.
Love.
Peace.